Hi, folks. My name is Shane. I'm the executive tour lead here at Jeptha Creed Distilleries in Shelbyville, Kentucky. I'm in charge of all your VIP experiences when you come into Shelbyville. And right now, what I want to show you is the fields that we've just harvested of the Bloody Butcher corn, of which we're up to over 450 acres. And as you can see, just brought in last week. Now, what is Bloody Butcher corn and why we use it and why it's making Jeptha Creed so popular? I'm going to show you right now. If you follow me on into our historic barrel barns, we'll have another conversation. This is the Bloody Butcher corn that we're famously known for here at Jeptha Creed. This corn just came out of the fields that I showed you just a few seconds ago. This corn has dated historically back to 1845 here in the United States. Open pollinated non-GMO corn. This corn will get to almost 15, 18 feet tall in some parts of our fields. During the milk stage, when you and I would pick this for dinner, it's actually a white corn. But shortly after that peak time, usually about the 1st of July, amazing transformation starts happening. This corn develops a little microscopic red dot on every kernel on this cob. And within about 15 days of that arrival, it shot burnt oranges, reds, and a splotchy pattern said to replicate a Bloody Butcher's apron. Now, this corn doesn't come out of the field in the volumes that other corns come out of. Today, crop reports here in Kentucky are listing at least 190 bushels an acre and upwards to 250 bushels an acre. We're only going to pull about 100 bushels an acre in a great year out of our fields due to wind loss because the corn is so tall. Thunderstorms come through, we're going to lose some that way. The deer, the raccoons come in, we're going to get hit that way, as well as the turkey and the squirrels, on and on. So it's a never-ending fight to harvest this. We've had to modify our corn equipment to bring this corn in. We have to take extra steps to size the seeds going into the ground. A lot more work goes into this. It costs more to do this corn, but doing a value-added project like what we have going on here at Jeptha Creed, you're going to see that this is going to be the corn of your choice going down. Well, this process goes back a little bit in the family history. What was going on was the patriarch of our family, Bruce Nethery, was always chirping in Mother Joyce's ear about distilling corn or having a distillery. And she had kind of put Bruce off on this for quite some time until she saw something happening in her own fields that convinced her otherwise that maybe this was a time to pursue this. And what she saw was when she had planted some heirloom tomatoes and some heirloom melons, she also planted about 15 acres of this Bloody Butcher corn. And she discovered something later in the season when she noticed that deer were going through fields of yellow and white corn to get to the Bloody Butcher corn. I think the light bulb went off for her at that point in time, and she says, hey, maybe, just maybe, Bruce might be right that this might make a good distillate. But they had to find out for sure. And that comes with quite a bit of expense because you can't go to a major distillery and say, hey, can you run us a test batch? So they did a test batch up in Madison, Wisconsin. And they sent the corn up, and of course they had that grown here and ground here, and they ordered wheat and rye to show up for their experiments at a craft distillery in Wisconsin. But what showed up on the doorstep was malted wheat and malted rye. Probably a good blessing in disguise, because combined with the unique sweetness of this corn and with the use of malted wheats and malted rye, gives us a great, unique flavor that we know you're gonna enjoy. This beautiful, sweet, incredible, nutty flavor of this corn shines through in our flagship 2-year straight bourbon at 98 proof. It's a thing of beauty, and you will enjoy it. Just wanted to take a second to show you the uniqueness of this corn from the ground up. Now, this corn is not shimmied up here in the rickhouse. This is just the natural height of this corn. You can see this corn is easily reaching 15 feet tall, and the cobs are hanging out at 8 feet. That's incredibly difficult to harvest. That's why we have to have GPS in our fields to bring this corn in. Now, during the milk stage, when you would buy this at the grocery store, like peaches and cream or Silver Queen corn. It's actually a white corn. Now, it tastes different than our corns today. Mother Joyce would tell you it tastes maltose sweet as opposed to sucrose sweet. What does that mean to us? That's that unique nutty flavor we keep talking about that you'll enjoy. Now, this corn in the milk stage is a little more fibrous, which means, yeah, you harken back to the day where you have to chew your food, but it's great corn. I love it stir-fried with Southwest flavorings. It's a beautiful thing. Just wanted to take a brief moment to share with you some different ways to use Bloody Butcher corn at home. Now, we have links listed below that you can enjoy some different recipes and some experiences with people that we've just partnered with would be Jack Fry's Restaurant and Chef Jonathan Exum, who's used a pecan chutney with our bourbon to show you a White Creek trout recipe on those links below. Now, I've used this not only for cornbread, but spoon bread, and I love Hatch Valley chili peppers with them. And I've also used this for corn dodgers, and you could look those up historically and find those to use at home as well. Okay, part of your experience that I want you to enjoy with Jeptha Creed products is our vodka, because that is the Bloody Butcher corn in its cleanest form. Now, as you know, vodka gets distilled between 190 and 200 proof, okay? We distilled a 191 and we proofed that down to 80 proof in our Jeptha Creed vodka, which is made with 100% Bloody Butcher corn. And that is going to give you the prevalent sweet note that we have throughout all of our products here at Jeptha Creed. And you'll discover upon tasting that you're not going to get that medicinal throaty grab that a lot of vodkas may give you. I tend to pick up a beautiful buttery note. Some people will say pine nuts, some people will say other experiences, but it's a beautiful buttery, almost a pear banana note. Banana seems to be the prevalent note that a lot of people grab to very quickly. For instance, it's still there, it ain't gonna go away. But next up on our experience in tasting from our vodkas, you're gonna be seeking that unique sweet note that is prevalent in the vodka is also apparent not only in our bourbons, but in our moonshines as well. In our bourbons, it really shines through with our four grain mash bill when we couple that up with malted wheat and malted rye. A thing of beauty in its own right, and you can't escape the unique sweetness that this corn has in our flagship straight bourbon. Beautiful notes in here, beautiful nose. I always tell people, enjoy the nose the most, because that's time for you to sip. Slow your processes down. Enjoy life a little bit more. I think we all need to take a lesson from that, don't you? Incredible sweetness to it. I think you're going to enjoy it, and I'm not going to do the Jedi mind trick and tell you everything you're going to get. I need you to try it for yourself. Now, one of the things you can enjoy here at Jeptha Creed is a barrel tasting experience here in the barrel barns with us. And we're going to walk you through tasting protocols and a way to slow your processes down and enjoy spirits in a whole new environment and a whole new process in a beautiful way. Welcome home to Jeptha Creed.